I've been waiting for this moment for a very long time. This is the one. This is the one that's going to change everything. This is Black Adam.
For the next 7 days, we are going to try to do The Rock's Black Adam workout routine.
The training split is chest and triceps. The movements today are, I'll start off with a fly, then I'll move to two compound movements, a press and then an incline press, and I will end that giant set. So that is three exercises in a row. And the fourth exercise will be a body weight dip and just rep it out till fatigue, until failure, and that is a son of a bitch. Then I'll do one more chest movement and then I will move on to triceps. Biceps. My entire back workout consists of all supersets. So there's a lot of blood and volume being pumped into the muscle, and then I'll transition to biceps. And as you guys know, with Black Adam, the prep for Black Adam, there's a lot of script and story and character and mythology study, all that fun literature stuff. But in terms of the physicality, I want to raise the bar with the character. He commands it. He believes in an eye for an eye, and he's the Dirty Harry of superheroes. And you know, if I fail, then at least I've given it my all. That's why I'm putting in all this work. Love you guys. Thank you for the support. You have a productive week. Talk soon. Excitement, all your support regarding Black Adam. You know, this particular workout for shoulders is designed to maximize the blood volume right out of the gate, and also make sure that the rep range is still in a place where we're still fine-tuning all the etching and all the detail of the muscle, keeping its hardness, but also making sure that even with the strict diet, we keep its fullness. I could read your mind. What the fuck does that even mean, Brock? It means we're coming to raise the bar with Black Adam. That's what it means. All right, thank you. You guys have a productive rest of your week. Again, thank you for all the support and the excitement for Black Adam. I'm excited too. This one comes from deep passion, the mana. Raise the bar. Here we go. Hardest workers in the room. Thursday, I'll train arms and the Thunder Cookies, as we call them. or as I call them, when I'm drunk. I'll train my arms and I'll probably train calves again on Thursday. And then I'll do cardio. Friday, at the end of the week, is when I ramp back up the intensity. That's when I train two major body parts in one day. I'll train chest and back. It's a big day, it's an intense day. And then I'll do my cardio again. Saturday to end the week is the biggest workout of the week. I train legs, and it requires the greatest amount of energy output. And it is a beast of a workout, but it's a great way to end the week. I will not do cardio after I train legs because I'm so exhausted. And I will stretch though. I'll probably throw in my calves again on leg day. And then on Sunday, usually what I like to do, if I have a full schedule, I'm actually working. My other job, I won't train, but since I'm not, I usually get my ass in here and start doing some sort of training or stretching or meditating or maybe a little cardio, maybe some abs, just something. And then I start the week right back up all over again. So.
I guess since my legs are pumped, I'll go ahead and show them now, because when they're not pumped, I'm probably not gonna show them.